matters, not only physically, but also spiritually.
Raya is a time of celebration with my friends and my family, and that really long raya night we have after Zuhur.
Raya for me is like a sunrise. It shines once a day, and Raya comes once a year. So we have to appreciate it and spend our time with our family.
Raya marks the end of Ramadan and is considered of gratitude to Allah as a Muslim. It is the time where we can celebrate it with family and friends.
Chicken rendang and ketupat.
Okay, so my favorite food during Hari Raya is any foods. But the foods must include the kuah kacang. I mean, like, the foods must be kicap with the kuah kacang.
I love rendang and not to forget nasi impit kuah kacang.
My favorite food during Hari Raya would be rendang, daging dendeng and also sambal udang.
So, my favorite food during Hari Raya is cornflake madu.
Guys, the highest amount of food raya I got for last year is 140.
I think the highest food raya I have ever got is around 500 ringgit.
Hi! Okay, my highest amount of food raya that I got before is 250 ringgit.
I think it's about a total of 400 ringgit when I was a kid.
The highest amount of food raya that I get before is 500 ringgit. And this one is one for you.
Hey, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Haris Idlan bin Muhammad Azhar. And people usually call me Potlet. And for today's episode, we're going to talk about Hari Raya bringing people together. Since we only have one day left before celebrating Hari Raya, let me share with you guys one of my story and what I usually do one day before celebrating Aidilfitri. So let's begin. So one day before Hari Raya, me, my family, my cousins, my uncles and my aunties, all of us usually will return to my grandma village located at Keluang Johor to help her preparing for Aidilfitri. And one of the activities that we usually do was cooking, or known as rewang, together, because in my grandma village, they have a tradition. They have some sort of tradition where when you give someone food, you need to return back. And this tradition acts as a symbol of a community relation among them, and it also strengthen the bond and strengthen the relationship among the people in that village. There are few type of dishes that we usually cook, like soy sauce chicken, ayam masak kicap, peanut sauce, or known as kuah kacang, sambal goreng, and kuah lebih. And also, and all of these dishes usually we will eat with either ketupat or nasi empit. So, when we arrived at my grandma house, my grandma, she already divided the task for everyone. Like for my mom, she will be the assistant chef. For my dad, he will buy any additional groceries. And for my sisters, since I am the only one guy. So I have 4 sisters, and all of them will do the chopping things. You know, like chopping onion, chopping the potatoes, and all the chopping things lah. And for my uncle, he will prepare the list name that we need to deliver the dishes. For my cousins, they need to lighten up the traditional stove using the coconut fiber and using the wood. Because usually when we had this kind of rewang during Aidilfitri or during Aidil Adha, we will cook at my grandma's special kitchen outside the house. While for me, I will sleep lah. Everyone do all the work. No lah. Okay, usually I will do all the frying things and cooking itself, and my grandma will just throw the ingredient into the big pot, and that is my task lah usually. Alright, so we will finish cooking around 2 or 3 o'clock in the evening and start to do the packaging around 4 o'clock, and we will start to deliver it after Asar from house to house according to the list given by my grandmother. I think this will end of my story of Hari Raya bringing people together. And I, Muhammad Haris Idlan bin Muhammad Azhar, would like to take this opportunity to wish you guys Selamat Hari Raya, maaf zahir dan batin, kosong-kosong.
Did
this year, I will celebrate Raya at Tanah Merah Kelantan with my family.
Well, due to PKP, I will celebrating Raya at Rawang Selangor and of course with my family.
So for this year, I'm going to celebrate my Hari Raya with my family in my hometown, which is Bentong.
I will celebrate with my family at my hometown at Sabah.
This year, I will be celebrating Aidilfitri in Putrajaya together with my family-in-law. No, I'm joking, just family.
It will be incomplete if I don't go shopping with my friends and family. Have you done your shopping?
Visiting your friends, family and also your neighbour.
Family, food, duit raya, firecrackers.
For me, raya will not be complete without wishes from my friends and family, also lagu raya.
It was on 2019 when all of my relatives and cousins gathered together at my grandmother's house in Kelantan. It was a moment filled with only happiness and joy.
Unforgettable moments during Raya that I always remember is gathering with family, because right now we are on COVID-19, so it's hard to gather. And yeah, unforgettable moments during Raya is gathering with family members.
I think it's the moment where you appreciate the creative side of you. In trying to avoid the inevitable questions like, when are you gonna get married? Where is he? Is he not coming? Did you guys break up? Like, I don't know! Okay?
The best memory have to be receiving the duit raya. And since I am older now and sometimes secretly hoping that I can get duit raya as well, because we all know that the older you are, the lesser duit raya you will get, right?
I'm a Pakistani girl who lives in Malaysia and never went back to my hometown. One day, my cousin surprised me by coming to Malaysia during the Eid. We played many games with each other and never forget that moment.
We are from Malaysia.
Hari.
Hiya.
Aidilfitri.
Hamzahin al-Batin.